there everyone, Hitesh here, back again with another video. Now in this video, we will talk about what is API, or also known as Application Programming Interface. Now this is a very common term, a very useful term, but there is a problem with our society or our computer society. We give zero F to whether people understand that subject or not, we just want it to be technically correct. So if you look up for the API definition on any platform, Wikipedia, blog, they are technically correct, that's one part, but they are not so much understandable. So in this video, we are going to make sure that you understand an API, what is API, and after watching this video, you never ever watch any video on API or blog because you will be understanding each and every bit of API. So let's get started. Let's talk about what is API. Now go ahead, open up your favorite search engine and try to look up for what is API. Let me help you and try to read what is written on your very favorite Wikipedia here. API, what is it? A set of function and procedure that allows to create of application which access the feature or data of an operating system, application or other services. Again, a mumbo jumbo. That means we don't get it what is API. Now the problem is this definition is perfectly correct. And the people who are using the API will be saying that, hey, this is a perfect definition and perfect point to understand. Now, here's the problem. The people who are already using the API don't need to understand what is API because they know about it. But the people who don't understand the API, we need to target that people. We need to make sure that they understand. So let me give you a quick example, and I'll give you two examples. We'll move on to our animation board very quickly. But the example of the API is very simple. Now, APIs is something which is helping you to have a seamless connectivity. You don't feel that you are getting connected with so much of the thing, but that API is actually helping. Now, remember the example, this one only, always, that when you try to book an airline ticket or maybe a railway ticket, you book it from a various website. Let's just say you want to fly from Jaipur to Delhi or Jaipur to Mumbai, and you choose your favorite Indigo Airlines. But how many times do you actually book from Indigo Airlines? You rarely does that. You use other services like makemytrip.com or maybe goibiba.com or any other such services. So how is that possible that you are booking from the third-party website but still you are getting a seat on the same plane? The answer is API. Now, before I move ahead and talk a little bit more about it, let's move on to our animation section and give you an example that you are already using of the API. Now let's try to understand what is this API, and we are going to use a simple example that some of you might have already used. So let me bring up my own website here, which is learncodeonline.in. Now some of you might have already registered on this website, and I would just say woohoo, self-promotion. So now let's just carry on and forward. That you might have seen that on this website we use a kind of a feature known as sign up. Now this sign up feature is pretty common. You just register with your name, email address, password, and then I send you a confirmation email at your email and you just click on that to verify. That is kind of a my way of handling the sign up. Pretty common, nothing so important, nothing so much serious to learn about that. Pretty common feature. Now on the other hand, now let's bring up Google. Now, as we all know that Google is a gigantic website, it writes a lot and lot and lot of code. Now, we all know that this kind of code is there on the Google for a variety of purposes, maybe for search engine, maybe for using Google Docs, maybe for login, sign up, there are tons of features on the Google. Now, we all also know that there is one of the very important feature in the Google, which is sign-in feature. You probably have been using that for Gmail or YouTube. So there is a login feature already being cooked up by the Google. So one of their code feature is login system. Now, if somehow I can use the Google login system, then it would be really awesome because Google has already taken care of things like verifying of the user, authenticity of the user. So it's already being done there. And if you notice that on our website, which is learncodeonline.in, we use a feature known as sign up with the Google. With one click, you can just use that. So what I'm using there is, I'm using some of the code written by Google, which is login in this case, and try to incorporate that in my website. Now, although this entire code is written by the Google, but I don't have to worry about what they have written, how they have written. I'm just fixing up a few of my variables and using the features of the Google that they have provided for me. And how actually am I able to do so? How am I able to provide you features of logging it with the Google? This is all through why API. And yes, with the help of API, you can do all such features like booking up for the airway tickets or things you have already seen. Like one of them is login with Google or login with the Facebook. Now there is one also key important aspect. If everybody will be able to use these kinds of APIs for free, there are high chances that it can get simply overused, or some people may use it for some nonsense purposes as well. So there is one more concept that sometime is introduced, also known as API key. Now, API key is again a method by which I sign up on the Google and take the permission of the Google that, hey, I want to use your login feature. And Google will say, hey, no problem at all. I'll give you a unique API key so that if you make any nonsense activity, I can track you and can shut down you. So this is your very, very basic example of how the API key works. So yes, that is it. This is it. This is your API. Now, there is no such extreme mumbo jumbo with the API. It's the simplest thing in the world, but yet the definition has made it so complex here. Now, onto a summary note, I would say that yes, API is just a code written by someone else that I don't really bother how it is being written, why it is being written, or what the circumstances would have been that why these people have written this code. All I care about is this is someone else's code that he's legally giving me permission to use that code, and I can use that in my application. For example, logging in with this Google or logging in with the Facebook are the most common example of using the API of Facebook and Google. And you might have seen other things as well. Like for example, if I want to just use or make a simple mobile app of weather application, I'm not Tony Stark. I'm not going to put any satellite into the space and that is going to calculate with the whole complexity things and going on there and will give me the data. Where will it rain or where will it not rain? So I'm not Tony Stark. I'm not going to put a satellite up there. But what I can do is some people have done that already and I can use their APIs. Now, some of the APIs are free and some of them are not. Like sign up with the Google is a free tier that you can use. But if you want to use the Google database and want to fix up everything on there, like live database that we call as live reloading database, that some of the part is free for the Firebase. And we'll talk about the Firebase in some other movies. But if your user base is growing, you have to pay them as well. So that is why the maintenance cost sometime is there a little bit. But onto a whole, let's forget about all that thing and focus again on API. So now you understand that API is a code written by someone else and you can use that code in your application, and that is it. Now sometime in that application, you have to use an API key as well so that the misuse of that code or that feature is not there, okay? So I hope you have understood what is API, and from now onwards, you will never ever look on what is API. Rather, you will be looking on the things that how I can use that API, that would be much more important. So basics all clear up, and maybe in some of the videos I'll try to make sure that you understand how APIs are being used as well. Let me know in the comment section down below that from which language you might want to utilize that feature, like whether we should use API with the JavaScript or PHP or maybe Swift or maybe Java, what you would like to see up next. Now also, I would request everybody to suggest me what should I make next on this channel. I'll be looking up on the comment section of each and every one comment so that I can get the topic of the next video. Pretty simple it sounds. Now one more thing, if you have missed that out in the last video, now I have decided that from now onwards I'll try to make sure that on every Sunday we go live and I talk to you guys live out there. I have realized that a lot of people love this, that when I go live, so I have decided that whenever I'll try to make sure that I go live on every Sunday. Now follow up my page on the Facebook, the links are in the description below, so that I can post on my Facebook page that what will be the timing of going live, because I hope you can understand I have other works as well that I have to accomplish as well. But yes, I'll try to make sure that you get the timing and most people can join up. In fact, I would be the happiest person to see that, hey, more people and more people are attending the live sessions. So with this, notify me in the comment section that how you like the idea of going live, and follow me up on my page as well, so that I can give you exact timing when I would be live. And with this, I'll surely catch you up in the next video.